Please welcome Intel CEO Pat Gelsinger.
It's wonderful to be back. What do you think? In person. Yeah. As the host of Innovation 2022, I have to affirm Intel's deep, unwavering commitment to an open ecosystem. We have a ton of news for you today in hardware, software, chip design, security, you know, new developer platforms, and everything the industry has to offer. We're going to geek out. We have seen the increasingly critical role that technology plays in every aspect of human existence. Everything is going digital. How we work, how we learn, how we rest, how we care for each other, how we worship, how we live in society and in community together. In this digital era, we continue to witness the magic of technology, our ability to push forward with innovation, discovery, and growth. For decades now, I've been in the debate, you know, is Moore's Law dead? And the answer is no. And with advances in transistors with RibbonFET, advances in power delivery with PowerVia, right, with breakthroughs in lithography with high INA lithography, the core of semiconductor manufacturing, with advanced packaging technologies, we aspire from today about 100 billion transistors on a single package. By the end of the decade, a trillion transistors. A trillion transistors in a single package. IFS will usher in what we call the systems foundry era. And as the focus moves from system on chip to system in a package, and we see a systems foundry having four components to it. And as part of our IDM 2.0 strategy, you know, we're committed to investing in the fundamental capabilities to enable this ecosystem, but also the next generation of talent as well. And part of our $1 billion IFS Innovation Fund is directly investing in companies and startups and disruptive technologies. I'm delighted today to announce our GPUs. We got not one, but three of them to describe today. And the first GPU is our Intel Data Center GPU Flex. And this is our Ponte Vecchio, our flagship high-performance GPU. And together, Ponte Vecchio, along with our Sapphire Rapids HBM, our fourth generation Xeon, right, is the computing brains behind the Aurora supercomputer. And together we're delivering these blades right now to Argonne National Labs to build the world's highest performance supercomputer. Here is the ARC 770, right? This is our top-end gaming desktop GPU packed with features. Deliver 65% better peak performance in ray tracing versus competition. I want to bring on stage a young, bright technologist who embodies that passion to harness technology as a force for good. Rhea Chairview, right, graduated high school at 11, started working at Intel as an intern at 14, the same year she received her undergraduate degree from Harvard. She's a whopping 18 years old today, the same age I was when I started at Intel. And you can imagine, on stage, I am now the underachiever. Please join me in welcoming Rhea to stage.
Hi, Pat.
So, you know, let's talk about this vast community, this vast universe of tools and technologies we're making available to innovators and developers like you, Rhea, and how we want to continue to provide easy, affordable access to the latest stuff, the Intel Developer Cloud, giving developers access to new and forthcoming hardware solutions for pre-launch development and testing.
Absolutely, and I think my peers are ready to get their hands on this technology and start innovating with it.
We're not trying to compete with the Amazon, Google, and Azures of the world, but to win your hearts and minds with early access of the latest great technologies that we're working on. And today, the Intel Developer Cloud is limited beta to, you know, select and pre-qualified customers, but our objective is to expand that significantly to developers over time for their platforms and to enable the scale of this service in the future. You'll have access to our latest technologies, you know, fourth gen Intel Xeon, also known as Sapphire Rapids, to Habana Labs Gaudi 2, right, to our advances in IPUs and, you know, our NEX technologies. We're going to set up a handful of challenges, and you're going to help me solve those challenges today. So our first challenge, speed up development cycles.
Thanks, Pat and Maria. So the challenge is really speeding up development cycles, and I have a tool that I think can help us with that. The Neural Coder, which is a new feature of the Intel Neural Compressor, is a one-click, no-code solution that removes hard-coded CUDA references from our deep learning scripts. It optimizes those scripts for performance, and it benchmarks those optimizations for the best possible deployment options. Let's take a look at how easy this really is.
So all I'm going to do here is go ahead and click the Run button and confirm, and is it that simple?
So that was pretty simple, right?
Let's get to our second challenge of the day. You know, so we saw that we can do them faster, but how do we make them more relevant to the marketplace, these AI models that we're doing, you know, and advanced, you know, without requiring an advanced degree in AI modeling?
I have good news for you. Okay. Intel has built an intuitive computer vision platform that enables anyone on enterprise teams to collaborate and build models very efficiently.
Jay, we are launching Intel Getty, powerful AI for everyone. And what you've seen here is this new computer vision platform lets anyone in the enterprise teams build computer vision models rapidly.
Hey, Pat, I hope you're hungry because the next live demonstration will take us into a restaurant.
Ooh, okay.
We help professional kitchen crews by eliminating manual estimation tasks. Our valued customer, Chipotle, focuses on enhancing the customer and the crew experience. Vision AI tells them how much inventory they have at hand and what to cook when to always serve the freshest food and to never stock out.
So let's move to our next challenge, if you would, game development. So, you know, modern games are complex. You know, they have, you know, interactivity, lifelike graphics, complex characters, story development, immersive experience. You know, and these are big, expensive development and production operations to bring them to market.
We are running four of these instances all at the same time with the same frame rate. And it is it performs wonderfully. And actually, in back, when I had a bit of downtime, I tried eight. And I was able to run eight of our game instances, which are only optimized for a single on the client at any one time. Just really impressive tech.
I am thrilled to reveal the 13th gen Intel Core desktop processor family. Formerly known as Raptor Lake, the flagship i9-13900K is coming next month. This is the fastest, best desktop processor ever built in history. It has blazing clock speeds of up to 5.8 gigahertz, and the i3-13900K is the best gaming, streaming, and recording experience ever. And whether you're a beginner or an expert, the Intel 13th Gen Core delivers the world's best overclocking experience as well. And you know, early next year, we'll release a SKU that for the first time ever hits 6 gigahertz out of the box in limited volumes. An industry first, a huge milestone for client computing. And I remember like it was yesterday when we first crossed 1 gigahertz. Man, you all are blowing me away. You know, 6 gigahertz, what a milestone. Congratulations to our team. So let's move into our fourth challenge, and this one's for content creators that need a creative boost. AI is unleashing this wide array of new opportunities for the creative process. And John is back on stage to show us some amazing technologies from Habana Labs using Gaudi 2. And maybe we can help create our movie poster, John?
Let's do it. So you mentioned text-to-image conversion, and we're running a latent diffusion model on our Gaudi 2 deep learning accelerator. Pat, Rhea, you want to start the creative process?
Well, how about movie poster?
So the Gaudi 2 is generating 16 images here in just under 3.5 seconds.
And, you know, John, I think what we've seen here is the incredible power of the next generation Gaudi processor. And here I have the Gaudi 2 accelerator. This product comfortably outperforms the A100, ResNet 50, BERT models, the June publication this year of the MLPerf benchmarks. You know, and this model we're running is latent diffusion on PyTorch.
The machine learning models, they bring joy. So I think this is fun. We're definitely done with this challenge and looking forward to seeing what comes next. Something that I really struggle with is you need a lot of devices in order to be able to do this type of content creation and being able to, you know, train your deep learning models, and those devices don't even talk to each other. I need a solution to being having to like lug around my very large monitor all the time.
Yeah, it's great to be here. So this is a small PC, right? But sometimes we need there's a bigger screen. So let's see. I'll show you the magic. Whoa. Oh. Oh.
Okay, my turn.
Okay.
Okay, I gotta play.
Okay.
Oh, wow.
Whoa. Okay. It's very important for Samsung Display to collaborate between ecosystem developers in hardware and software together to achieve this kind of innovative form factor PCs for best user scenarios. So let me have this one. So today we announced world first 17-inch slidable display for PC globally for the first time.
Thank you.
Wow.
Earlier this year at the CES show, we announced our acquisition of Screenovate. And this is, you know, now coming forward as Intel Unison. And to show an example of Intel Unison, please join our demo geek, Craig, coming to stage.
What we're saying with Unison and the promise of Unison is to bring all of our devices together, regardless of ecosystem or how they move and how they interact, all of our smart devices, again, really working for us in the way that we want to.
You're telling me that could I connect like my iPhone to the device or?
Rhea, that's exactly what I'm telling you.
All right.
All of your devices. That includes iOS and Android device like this, all working together for the first time with our Windows PC.
And at Intel, we invest for the long term. You know, we know that optics, this dramatic amount of bandwidth, you know, moving from photons to electrons, crossing the optical electrical boundary, this was hard. And bringing light and bandwidth and low power right up to the package, and then scaling it for the industry to participate in it. So here we are, and we can now show this breakthrough. Our engineering team has done it, and they've built a detachable optical in-package connector coming directly into a glass substrate. Let's go live to our lab in Scotland and take a look to show it for the very first time.
So here we go. So we got power coming into directly the silicon photonic package. The green signal, that means we're measuring light all the way through the package. But we have to show that it's also detachable. So we're going to detach it, reattach it again, and we'll be able to show that here now live. Okay, John. So there we go, we've detached it, signal's dropped off, reattaching it, and now the signal's jumping back up again. Okay?
Hey, Russell and team, yo, thank you so much. This is exactly how I dreamed of it decades ago. And you guys are now delivering it. Thank you. Congratulations to our team in Scotland. So, Rhea, you know, thank you for joining me on this journey. You know, in 30 years, when you're on stage as the CEO, remember to continue to pass on the shared passion that we have for the world of technology and the enormous positive tech for good impact that it can have.
Oh, absolutely, Pat. And I think on behalf of developers everywhere, we're ready to get these technologies running, working for our workflows, optimized, accelerated, and changing the world.
We've talked about our commitment to being open, systems and software and hardware standards, and our collective potential as an industry is unleashed when we enable openness, choice, and trust. So to close out, I want to bring on stage a special guest, someone that I have personally admired for decades, a no bigger champion of open collaborative ecosystems, the godfather of the open source movement, the creator of Linux kernel and of Git. Please join me in welcoming none other than Linus Torbolds.
One thing I really strive for is to make sure that people feel like they are part of I don't want to say the community. I mean, it is part of the community, but they're part of making decisions, and they really own the end result.
Invested in it.
They're invested in it.
That today we are honored to give you and recognize you and our community as we come here together, right? You know, we would like to say that you are the first recipient of the first ever Intel Innovation Award. Our objective here is that developers, whether software or hardware, you see the future, and our job at Intel is to open that future up to you, working together on open frameworks that you can trust. I'm excited we've had the opportunity to come together to learn, grow, build, challenge, and help each other. And together, we've taken a peek into the future, one that we will create together. Thank you.